Hey, students and friends from around the world, thank you so much for joining me in this live session of today's class entitled Candlestick Trading. Ladies and gentlemen, truly, I really appreciate you guys taking the time to be with me today and or tonight, depending on where you might be. Just got done from having a nice workout, did some Pilates with the girlfriend. it was pretty tough, guys, I'll be honest. Watched two episodes of How I Met Your Mother, had some chicken, rice, and peas, and now it's time to do a little bit of this action. So, what we're discussing today really is quite important, and there's many blogs and articles and other videos that I'll be doing and basing this information on in the future. However, in today's class, let's cover the basics of candlesticks, what they mean, what the sentiment is, and we'll discuss a few patterns, and I'll give you real-life examples on what they look like. So, number one, let's talk about the formation of the candlestick pattern. The candlestick is a sentiment indicator. Now, I say sentiment indicator because it really shows you identically what happened during the day. And it shows you exactly what happened during the day. So, for example, let's take this candle right here. The big, nice, long, white one. Now, the open of a white candle is at the very, very bottom. So anytime there's a white candle, you are guaranteed the fact that the stock closed higher than the open, if it's a white candle. Now, keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, there are other various candle colors. Many traders use red and green, red being the down days and green being the up days. The reason I personally don't choose red and green candles, number one, is because I learned on white and black. But number two, green and red kind of does have a psychology tied to it. Psychology being green is up, green makes money, down is bad, down loses money, red is bad, red loses money, that type of thing. So green's up, down is bad. And really, that's not the psychology we want to use. We want to use and be super neutral in any market, in any environment, being able to make money. So a white candle shows the open of the day. Now, from there, you will also have the low of the day oftentimes. The low of the day is represented by a shadow, also known as a wick, spelled W-I-C-K, just like a candle wick. So as each and every one of you know, the market opens at 9:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And at some point, there will be a low during the day. So trivia question, ladies and gentlemen, can the open and the low of the day be the exact same? And the answer to that question is yes. Here's an example right here, where the low and the open is the exact same. So truly what that means is when the stock opens that day, as soon as it opens, it continues. The instant the market opens, the stock continues higher and buying pressure really takes over on that particular trade. That's really important to note. A candle that is represented, a white candle that's represented when the open and the low are the exact same is called a shaved bottom candle. And shaved bottom candles, ladies and gentlemen, reveal buying pressure. There's one there, there's one there, there's one there, there's one there, there's one there. And you guys can see that shaved bottom candles did lead oftentimes to higher moves. So shaved bottom candles represent good buying pressure. Now, when the candle closes above the open, it creates a white candle. So the close of white candles are always at the top, okay? The wick or the shadow represents the high of the day. So the stock doesn't have to have a high. The high and the close can be the exact same. And that's called a shaved top candle. So if the high and the close of the white candle are the exact same, it's called a shaved top candle, which is an example right there. It's pointing to the pink arrow, the white candle. Now, that's also called a Marabozu candle. And a Marabozu candle is a white candle that has the same open and the same low, and the close is the same as the high. So the open matches the low, and the close matches the high. You can also have a black Marabozu candle. Black Marabozu candle is when the open and the close are the same as the low and the high. So better said, the open matches the high on a bearish candle, and the close matches the low on the bearish candle. Let's see if I can find one on Apple. I don't really think I can. Apple isn't really known to be Marbozu. This one's pretty dang close. So we can get an idea of what that is. Now, it's obviously not exactly a Marbozu candle, but it's really, really close. So on a Marbozu candle, the open is the exact same as the high, and the low is the exact same as the close. Those are both very, very bearish candlestick patterns. Now, in regards to wicks and or shadows, here's a pretty much constant. The lower shadow always represents buying pressure. Always. Lower shadows always represent buying pressure. So ladies and gentlemen, you guys tell me which candle has the strongest buying pressure based on the lower wick. Is it the candle I'm pointing to in black? Is it the candle I'm pointing to in green? Or is it the candle that I'm pointing to in orange? Which one represents the strongest buying pressure? And the answer is, of course, orange, right? The lower shadow is longer than all of the other candles combined, so green and black. So it's a very, very strong candle, right? Nice, long, lower shadow. Now, upper shadows reveal selling pressure. So the more and the higher an upper shadow is, the more selling pressure that is involved. So you guys can see in this candle right here, really nice selling pressure. So the way it is created is at some point during the day, let's kind of zoom in so we can see this candle a little bit better. This is really the kind of the most bearish candle that we have on Apple. Apple doesn't have a lot of bearish candles at the moment. All right, here we go. So this particular candle is created by Such. So it opens right here. So let's talk about the story and the sentiment of this particular candle. And what will help us is by reading the story of the prior day. So let's start back in from here. We have a really nice bullish candle. Stock goes a little bit higher and then pulls back. We get a small white candle, which is a bullish candle with the lower shadow. Lower shadows represent buying pressure. So some buying pressure came in on that particular candle. Caused the stock to go a little bit higher. We pulled back once again. And then we got a white candle. And the body of the white candle fully engulfed the prior day's candle. This is called a bullish engulfing candle. So you can see the body of the white candle fully engulfs the prior day's candle. From there, the stock continues higher and higher and higher and trades up, trades up, trades up. And at about this price right here, people really begin to get concerned about how steep Apple is going. Notice this has been going up and up and up and up and up. So when the stock opens that day, people are like, oh my gosh, I'm missing the bullish move, right? So they begin to buy, causing the stock to go higher and higher and higher. And then at some point, what begins to happen, ladies and gentlemen? Who begins to sell here? And the answer that you're likely looking at is the profit takers. The profit takers are the ones who begin to sell. They begin to take their profits. That simple. So how do they take their profits, ladies and gentlemen? By selling. Yes, by selling. So they begin selling, and then the stock goes down and 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 goes down. And then at some point during the day, someone, let's call them the orange trader, who did not get the opportunity to buy yet, they see this pullback as a buying opportunity, they begin to buy. So you get a black candle with an upper and lower shadow. These are called indecision candles. And when you see this, it really means to just wait and be patient. Something is upcoming, something's approaching, but we don't know exactly what yet. The next day, ladies and gentlemen, the stock opens a little bit higher than the close of the previous day. And then it continues to trade down, trade down, trade down, and we get a lower shadow. The lower shadow creates what type of pressure, ladies and gentlemen? Of course, yes, buying pressure. Buying pressure drives the candle and the price higher. Okay, so it goes up, it goes up, it goes up. And then the preceding candles, ladies and gentlemen, is it really any giant surprise that the preceding candles, the candles that come after, are white candles, because we can look and say pretty obvious that the lower shadow is much stronger than the upper shadow on this candle. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Now, most of you are saying, oh, that's really cool. I mean, so you can see the buying pressure and the stock continue higher, and absolutely. And as a matter of fact, it forms a 4-day candlestick pattern. So this is the candlestick pattern outlined in green. I'll try it again a little bit clearer. There it is. It forms a pattern which is called a rest after battle. A rest after battle is actually a continuation candlestick pattern where two black candles are in the middle of two white candles. Now, what's important is that the second day black candle cannot be and cannot close lower than the open of the first day. So here's the first day's pattern right there, and you can see that the stock did not close lower than the open of the first day. Now, rest after battles can have two or more candles in between the two white ones. So you could have two white candles, and you could have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, doesn't matter, in between the two white candles. So these candles are what's called a rest after battle, right? You have two black candles, and it looks kind of like a sandwich, right? And it really creates some rest, right? So the buyers get some rest right here. They continue to pick up the steam, and then the trade continues higher. Now, notice that this stock from here to here, Apple on this day, so this day is June 9th. From June 9th to June 10th, the stock gaps up. Now, you're going to say, how do I know that? Well, look at the close of the June 9th candle. Okay. Look at the open of the June 10th candle. There's obviously a discrepancy there. So the stock gapped higher. So here's the question I have for you, ladies and gentlemen. Did this candle close higher than the prior day's close? And the answer is yes, it did. So that candle on June 10th, or that day in Apple's history, would actually show as an up day. So if you're going to Yahoo Finance and you type it in, this candle closed at, I think, 93.65 or somewhere pretty dang close to that. And then the next day closed at 94.25. So you're looking at approximately 40 cent difference in the close of the prior day. However, we can look at the sentiment of this candle and read a different story. Even though we had an up day, ladies and gentlemen, notice that when the stock gapped up, it immediately started selling. And then we got some upper shadow and some lower shadow. So again, we got an indecision candle. And the next day, we also got an indecision candle. It's called a spinning top. So the spinning top candle is a candle that has a nice, cute, square type of body. So I'll point to some spinning tops. So here's a spinning top. 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 So these are spinning tops, right? This is not a spinning top because the candle's way too big. The spinning top has a cute little perfect rectangular body, and they often are the first indicators of a reversal as far as the sentiment is concerned. So when the stock gapped up and we got a spinning top indecision type of candle, and we got another indecision type of candle, you really could have said, interesting. These three candles together actually create something called the evening star reversal. So when you get a white candle followed by a black candle, and textbook example, you want the black candle to gap up, right? And you want it to open and close above the close of the prior day. So it gaps up, sellers begin to take some profit, and you get a black candle, but it's still higher than the prior day's close. Then the next day, usually you get another lower high and a lower low relative to the second day. This really is a quite nice evening star reversal pattern. Now, in an evening star reversal pattern, usually, especially if you're at a confirmed resistance, your entry can be right here and your stop can be right here in black. That could be, your entry can be in orange and your stop can be in black. In this particular situation on Apple, we weren't really at a confirmed resistance. The all-time high was about 100 after the 1-7 split. So we weren't really at a confirmed resistance. What that means to you as a trader is simply this. The orange line could have been the indication for you to either A, go bearish, or B, simply not go bullish yet. And usually, if you're not at a confirmed resistance, and since we're in a strong bullish trend on Apple, I would have taken the latter. I would have said, hey, I'm not going to go bearish yet. Or I apologize. I'm not going to go bullish yet. I'm going to wait. So as the stock traded lower and lower, and you see that it pulled back and then continued a little bit lower, this is the exact opposite of an evening star reversal pattern. It's called a morning star reversal pattern. A morning star reversal pattern is when you get a black candle, okay? The stock gaps down. Now, this is a tiny gap. I'll grant you that, but it gaps down. So the open of the prior day, the third day in the situation, this is June 25th, the open is lower than the close of the first day black candle, okay? And the second candle is a spinning top type of candle. It's a small body. And then the next day is a white candle that makes a higher high and a higher low. You really do, in a morning star reversal, you want the third candle to make a higher high and a higher low. Just like in the evening star reversal, you want the third candle to make a lower high and a lower low. So those are some of my favorite reversal patterns, and the way you would trade this again, especially if it pulled into any type of moving average or support, is you look at the reversal pattern, you see, oh my gosh, this looks like a really good entry. Your entry would be the orange line, your stop would be the pink line, and target one would be the recent high, which is about a 1-2.5, 1-3 risk to reward ratio. So that's kind of an example of some of the sentiment of a candlestick patterns. Let's talk a little bit more about this particular pattern, this particular candlestick pattern right here. This is actually the opposite of the one that I've taught you quite often in section one. This is called a one black crow. One black crow. And a one black crow is a black candle that opens lower than the close of the prior day and closes below the open of the prior day. So notice that this trader, let's say someone bought here, let's call that person Joe. Joe decides to buy on this day, ladies and gentlemen, and it creates a nice white spinning top candle, which is already, as you guys know, an indecision candle. It doesn't show a lot of strength. So the next day, when the black candle is formed, it opens already lower than the close of the prior day. So what would Joe be thinking? Joe is thinking, oh my goodness, I'm losing money. And he doesn't want to lose money, so he's scared. Well, then at some point, all of the prior day gets taken out, and we get a massive black candle with increased volume that does in fact open and close below the prior day's open, which is a pretty bearish candle. Now, this was at a nice resistance, but wasn't quite at a perfect all-time high. The all-time high on Apple, if we go back here, and we can draw that in so you can see it. Okay, let's hop over here, horizontal line. I'll just come and click on that really quick, right about there. That's the all-time high. So by the time the one black crow candle formed, we had already passed the all-time high, which simply meant to me that we're likely going to rest or consolidate a little bit on Apple. Now, let's really take a strong look into this candle for a moment. This candle was the announcement of the iPhone 6 and the iWatch. I'll remember that one for a while. I didn't trade it, but I made sure people were very, very careful about trading it. Ladies and gentlemen, what does that candle say to you? Well, it says to me that it's very indecisive. It's kind of like my girlfriend deciding where to go for dinner. Just has no idea, can't make up its mind, right? At one point during the day, the stock went really, really, really high. people were buying it. People were buying it. They thought, oh my goodness, this is the coolest thing ever since the, you know, the invention of fire. And then everyone who did not sell, this was beautiful, guys. Everyone who did not sell right here because of the one black crow, they're now like, oh my gosh, finally I get a chance to recuperate my losses. So they begin to sell. They begin to sell. And then you have all the people who really didn't get a chance to buy in during this bullish run. And they go, oh great, finally a pullback. So they begin to buy. And so you create this giant high wave. That's what the candle's called. Upper shadow and lower shadow. So you get a giant high wave candle. A high wave candle is a candle that has a massive upper shadow and a massive lower shadow. Once you see these type of candles, you can pretty much guarantee that the stock is going to trade sideways for a little bit because it's very, very indecisive. So let's ask the question then, did and has Apple traded sideways and been kind of indecisive since that day? And my answer would be yes. We've made higher lows, but we've also made lower highs on Apple. So my thought process would be we're likely going to trade sideways for a few more days, but if we break strongly out of this pattern, it could give us an indication of what direction Apple could go for the foreseeable future. So it's really, really interesting to see, to find out what happens. So that's the one black crow. I also have another name for the candle. Any candle that is a black candle that's not quite like a one black crow. So in most textbooks or other companies or universities or websites or online education companies, what'll be described as a one black crow is a long day black candle that appears at resistance, which I totally agree with. However, you'll often find black candles that open and close below the prior day's close. These are strong candles, and they may not be long day candles, and they may not necessarily occur at a resistance, but I can promise you they're very, very strong patterns. They're great patterns to get in a trend if the trend, especially if the trend, is already bearish. So let's kind of hop over to one, see if I can find one. I'm pretty sure I can. I'll be looking for one that's already in a bearish trend. So we're coming back now to 2013 on Apple, and right here is a perfect indication of that trade. So you can see that we're at some type of resistance level on Apple, but we get a black candle that opens and closes below the prior day white candle's close. I call this candle a new black crow. The reason I call it a new black crow is because some of my students in my live trading room, they kind of coined it that because I didn't really come up with a name for it. And I'm not saying that it's in no other textbook or no other instructor or company talked about this particular candle, but they don't use it as often as I do. And I did have some pretty solid success with this particular candlestick pattern because it's all about the location and where it appears and the sentiment behind it. For example, you'll notice there's one right here, right? So this is a, you could also call this a one black crow. Since it does occur at a resistance and it is a long day candle. So all one black crows are new black crows, but not all new black crows are one black crows. That's how that works. By the way, this appears to be an evening star reversal pattern. Ladies and gentlemen, what type of pattern would you guys call this right here? Exactly, that is a morning star reversal pattern. I would also, I could argue that this down here is also a morning star reversal pattern. And of course, you see, here's the new black crow. Here's the black candle that opens and closes below the prior day white candle's close. Here's another one. So how do you trade these little guys? Well, if you see this candle, especially if it's in a downtrend or the stock's trading sideways, your entry could be right below the black candle, and your stop can either be above the most recent swing high, which is right here, or in some, you know, in some cases, it can be above the actual black candle itself. Let's see if I can think if I can find another one earlier in the trend. Let's see if we can find one when Apple was really, really tanking. I can almost guarantee we can find at least one. Ah, how lovely. Here's the one black crow on Apple once the debacle started happening in 2012. That really kind of set the match, so to speak. Here is what I would decipher as a new black crow because you know, it's not really out of resistance anymore. It's already trading lower. So it's a black candle that opens and closes below the prior day white candle's close. Here's another one, another black candle that opens and closes below the prior day white candle's close. So your entrance could have been there and your stop could have been right there. Imagine that risk to reward. I mean, that's phenomenal. This is already a 1-3, 1-4 risk reward down there. And then the trade just continues and continues and continues. Here is an evening star reversal pattern right there. And so you guys can kind of see the differences. I mean, each candlestick pattern is really going to have its own nuances and its own specialties and its own strengths and or weaknesses. The pattern that I talked about in the first segment of this class, the first section, was the one white soldier. And this is an example of a one white soldier. Now, granted, it didn't really occur at a support line, but you can see that we did have a higher move afterwards. So a one white soldier is the exact opposite. A one white soldier is a white candle that opens and closes above the prior day black candle's close. A new white soldier is a white candle in a trend, just like the new black crow, that opens and closes above the prior day black candle's close. So again, ladies and gentlemen, morning star reversal pattern right there. And then white candle that opens and closes above the prior day black candle's close. Entrance, stop, target. And again, that's about a 1-2, 1-3 risk to reward ratio, which again is quite solid. You can see plenty of other new white soldiers on Apple. I mean, Apple loves them. Here's one right here. Here's a new white soldier. There's a new white soldier. There's a new black crow. Here's a new black crow out of resistance. Here's a new black crow right there. Let's go find a few more. Here's a new black crow right there. Here's a new black crow right there. And you can see the prior days, they really did and oftentimes do have some selling pressure and or some buying pressure. This was one of the better new white soldiers on Apple for a while. This one right here. It was just so perfect that it occurred. You know, we had some higher lows. We had some lower highs. It looked like some type of chart pattern. And this candle, ladies and gentlemen, the one I'm pointing to in green, what makes it such a nice new white soldier? Well, in my opinion, it's the fact that it has a shaved top. Remember? So here's a resistance. Resistance, support. And you have a new white soldier, a white candle that opens and closes above the prior day black candle's close, and it has a shaved top. Shaved top representing, of course, a lot of buying pressure. So I'm not saying that you had to be Houdini and, you know, set your buying entry level there and your stop right there. But I'm saying, could you have done that? And I would argue, yeah, absolutely. And if you didn't, could you still have had the opportunity to recognize the fact that based on that one candle alone and the support and resistance of that price point, that you could have been either bullish or just simply not have been bearish? And in my interpretation, the answer would be, yeah, absolutely. So I think that's a really quite interesting candle pattern. And if we come to present day on Apple, we can see an actual evening star reversal pattern right there that didn't really quite occur perfectly at a resistance, but really, really close. And if you guys were thinking this kind of looks similar to an evening star reversal pattern, I would agree. As far as the sentiment, it does. Right? First day is a white candle. Second day is a black candle. And the open is higher than the close of the prior day. And then the third day makes a lower low and a lower high. So in which case on Apple, if we continue a little bit lower, I agree with you. My thought process is also that we might get a little bit more of a pullback on Apple. Since you guys will be looking at this in the future, for those who are watching this as a recording, let's hop over to DDD really quickly so that I can look at a new black crow that I was looking at recently in our live trading room so that you guys can kind of see how this might play out by the time that you're watching this video. Here is the horizontal line. So let's go chart our stock. And again, look for white space. Look for the location to where this chart stops moving. If it helps and you want to use a line chart to do this, you absolutely can. You just kind of come over here and click on line. There you go. And you come back over here and you click on horizontal line, and you can just go ahead and draw your line. Boop. There's one right there. And let me just show you the support levels that I'm looking at. So obviously what comes to mind first is that resistance right there. Would you guys agree that the stock just totally stops moving right there? Just hit a brick wall. You obviously have some congestion right there where the stock traded around that particular price point. We had a perfect stop right there. We had a perfect stop right there and a few breaches. Now, present day data, okay, we're making lower lows and lower highs on that particular price point. So I could have drawn another line or just move this one down and move it down to here. And you can see that we're still breaking that line even. And that line we could base off of this peak. We could base off of this peak. So that's two touches. And we got some congestion around here. Let's zoom into present data on DDD and just see what it looks like. So here's our candlesticks. Let's zoom in really nice and close here. And let's ask some questions. If 4481 is a support or was a support, what type of line and what type of price point would that 4481 be now? And if you're saying resistance, I would give you a high five, a pat on the back, and say yes. In my opinion, that would be a resistance. Now we have a black candle that opens and closes below the prior day white candle's close. We're already making lower lows and lower highs in the trend. We're bearish in the trend overall. So what if we had a bearish entry approximately here at 42.12, and our stop was above this line at 45.40? Ladies and gentlemen, does that make sense to you? Remember, in section one, we talked about proper stop placement. We're placing the stop above the wick of this candle right here, and we're placing the stop above old support, new resistance. So in my opinion, that's one for you guys to keep an eye on. I welcome you to hop over to TradingView and DDD and look how that played out. Regardless, ladies and gentlemen, let's just say hypothetically, this trade doesn't go properly and it doesn't work out and we lose on the trade. How much are we going to lose? One risk unit, one R, exactly. So you guys are starting to see how this comes together, right? You're starting to piece the support, resistance, the candlesticks, and the sentiment, and the risk mitigation. And from there, it really is that simple. So in the next class, what we're going to do is talk about some of my favorite chart patterns. And I know I'm not going through everything that exists in the stock market world right now, but that's simply because we don't need to, right? Let's master the basics. Let's make sure that you guys understand this. And if you have questions on this, let's hash this out. Let's make sure you're concrete and firm and you have a solid grasp on these concepts and these data points as far as the candles and the risk mitigation, the support and resistance. And as you continue, we'll make sure you become a master of these important and crucial information as it relates to the stock market and technical analysis. And as we progress closer towards mastery, we can get into the more finer details. So again, if you have any questions, feel free to email us, email the team at support@reallifetrading.com. You can email me anytime at jeremy@reallifetrading.com. Find me on Twitter at Newsome Nuggets. You can find our Facebook page. And ladies and gentlemen, make sure to tell the world about us because we are here to enrich just that, enrich lives from around the world. That's our mission statement here at Real Life Trading, where we are simply real traders, real people with real results. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. I truly appreciate it. Remember, love life, live life, and trade it. Welcome to Real Life Trading.